Welcome to the How to Create Your Own Railing Template for SolidSteel Parametric Tutorial. You will learn how to create your own railing template with the appropriate variables. The result will be what is already shown here, a railing that automatically adapts to the length and angle of the installation situation with a variable number of middle posts and filler rods. Our main railing, on which we will show the most steps, is a top-mounted railing, but at the end of the video you will also learn how to create a side-mounted one. Let's go, we create a new part, and save it under any name, I call it preview part. Then we create an assembly in which we place the preview part we have just created. And we save the assembly as well. For a better overview, we make the center point visible and select the XY plane to sketch a side view of the railing. In SolidSteel Parametric, plus Y is the default top direction, but you can change this in the settings if, for example, you prefer plus Z as the top direction. First, we draw four vertical and two diagonal lines of any length, just as freely in offset so that no unintended constraints are snapped. One of the vertical lines is placed at the origin as a construction line. This line will later be used to define the angle of inclination of the railing. The first railing post is also placed at the origin. We set the length of the other post equal to the length of the first post. Now we align the diagonal line which will later correspond to the handrail at the top of the first post and then align the other posts with the diagonal line. We place the short diagonal brace between the first and second post and align it parallel to the handrail. The basic sketch is complete, and we can now dimension it. The first post, for example, is set to 1000 mm. The other posts change immediately because they are set equal. We now set the overhangs to 400 mm for example. I have now set the dimensions parallel to the handrail, otherwise horizontal dimensions can result in very long overhangs especially with steep railings. Then we dimension the distance from the first post to the third post, which is the base length also parallel to the handrail. And now the distance from the first to the second post. The distance between the verticals is still missing, as well as the angle from the construction line to the handrail. Our sketch is now complete. Now we can start creating the parameters to control the sketch. For the basic parameters, length, height, and angle, it is important that they are named exactly as specified in the user manual, so that your own template will work as intended later. All other parameters to be displayed in the railing dialog must begin with SSP but can otherwise be named freely. Click Add Numeric to add user parameters and start with the base parameters. It is necessary to select the correct unit and enter a value in the equation column. SSP handrail offset later controls the length of the overhangs. SSP post pattern controls the number of posts. Here we choose UL as unit slash type, which means unitless, because it is only about the number and does not need a unit. I'll skip ahead a little, the parameters are all named so you can determine what they're for. The parameters that do not begin with SSP are named as such so that they do not appear in the railing dialog. I move the parameter dialog so we can see the sketch at the same time, and can watch how the sketch changes as each equation is defined. Now we link the user parameters to the model parameters with an equation, for example for the angle 90° minus SSP angle. In other words, the 90 degrees of the vertical construction line minus the angle entered by the user. The equations of the basic geometry are even simpler. They correspond exactly to the user parameters, so we only have to enter the names of the parameters. For the variables, such as the number of filler bars or posts, it is a little more complex, but again, we just need to establish mathematical relationships between the user parameters. This looks more complicated than it is, just pause the video and take your time to look at the details. Okay, that completes the sketch so far. We take a look at it, and see that all the dimensions now start with FX, so everything looks right. We can switch to the SolidSteel tab to place the desired profiles for the railing. I am using round tubes, but of course you have all the options here. The profiles for the handrail and the post are the same, so we can select the corresponding sketch lines at the same time. Confirm to insert the profiles. I choose a thinner tube for the extra fill rods. Confirm. I forgot the second post, so I'll quickly add it. Now it's done. As we can see, we now have the entire outer railing frame, but only one inner post and only one inner filler bar. We use linear patterns to control the inner elements. We start with the inner post. The direction in which the pattern is created corresponds to the handrail. We choose this face because the face normal is correctly oriented to define the direction of the pattern. We define the number of copies via our user parameter SSP post pattern, and the distance is defined via inner length DIST. The preview looks correct, we can confirm. Next, we pattern the fill rods. Here the pattern has two directions, vertical for the number of rods and horizontal for the number of segments. We select this face as the reference for the first direction. We use our variable named SSP inner height pattern for the number and inner height DIST for the distance. In the preview, we see the second fill rod as the result, we can confirm. The second direction is still missing. So we pattern the pattern we just created and again select the face on the handrail as the reference for the direction. Number using the inner length pattern parameter and distances using inner length DIST. Preview fits, confirm, and this part of the job is done. Now we test our work to make sure everything is updated correctly. For example, I change the angle, the sketch changes correctly, and I confirm the changes with done. Now the parametric update in SolidSteel follows and it looks good and right too. We can congratulate ourselves, most of the work is done. To add our own railing to the database for future use, we now use the Learn Railing feature. We will simply go through the Learn Railing dialog from top to bottom, starting with a name for the railing. I choose top railing because it is a top-mounted railing. Image path allows us to define a preview image that will be displayed in the placement dialog. With parameters, we can control which parameters can be changed and are displayed in the dialog during placement. SSP angle and SSP base length are automatically calculated when the railing is inserted based on the installation situation. It does not make sense for the user to change these parameters. Therefore, these values are disabled for editing, but are still displayed with visible. The parameters whose names do not begin with SSP are not even listed in the dialog, so the rest can be left as they are. To finish the railing, confirm with execute, and the new railing is added to the database. From now on, we can use the new railing in different installation situations with just a few clicks. Let's test it right away. Here we have a horizontal beam and a slightly sloped beam. We activate the railing feature and simply select the top face of the beam where we want to place the railing. Under name in the dialog, we now select the name just assigned to the railing, immediately see a schematic preview in 3D and the preview image of the railing in the dialog. If the displayed parameters meet our needs, we can confirm immediately and the railing is inserted. Well, directly again on the slanted profile, select face. Select railing. The preview appears and we could also insert this railing right now. Before we do that, let's take a quick look at the dialog. Here in the offset area, we could use the start and end offset to control the baseline length and thus move the posts as required. For example, 100 millimeters in each case. Of course, we can also make settings in the parameters we have created ourselves. For example, increasing the overhang to 400 millimeters. In the parameters, we also see the two grayed out parameters at the beginning, and why it is good that we let the computer calculate these values exactly and not require the user to do so is self-explanatory with the crooked numbers. A click on execute inserts the railing adapted to the slope of the beam, and the changed parameters are also considered. Well, that was our top-mounted railing, now we'll create a side-mounted one. Don't worry, the steps for side-mounted railings are largely identical, so we'll fast forward, but there are a few important differences and we'll take a look at them now. Let's start with the sketch. The preview part and a new assembly for the railing have already been created. We'll display the center point and the XY plane as usual, but we'll also need the YZ plane for the side mounting and an offset plane based on the XY plane, let's say with an offset of 150 millimeters. The sketch of the actual railing is created on the offset plane, and only a single line is created on the YZ plane, which we will later use to control the lateral offset of the railing. We draw the line in the length of the offset of the additional plane just created, which is 150 millimeters. As already mentioned, the sketch for the railing is largely identical to the sketch for the top mount railing, so here's a quick run through. The second difference for the side mount sketch is that we extend the railing posts downwards. We add a point to the first railing post and then measure from the point to the bottom of the post and the height up as before. The lower measurement will be used later to adjust the overhang. We place the post with the added point at the origin. Everything else in the creation of the sketch is absolutely identical to the first railing. I skip the rest to keep the video short. This is the finished sketch, rotated so you can see the 150 mm offset and the overhang at the bottom. The parameters that control the sketch are now defined. You already know most of them from the top rail, but the two parameters SSP side distance and SSP bottom offset are added to control the sketch, as well as the parameter connection pattern, which defines the number of side connectors required. With a total of 12 user parameters, everything is defined: the angle, all lengths, all heights, all overhangs, and also the numbers for the patterns. We can now link these parameters to the sketch. We need the side distance in two places. Once to define the distance to the offset plane, and once for the length of the side mountings. The other values correspond to the scheme of the first railing plus another value for the lower offset of the posts. The next step is to place the profiles in SolidSteel parametric. This is also largely identical and therefore in fast forward. The only difference is that I used a flat steel bar at the bottom for mounting. Now it's time to define the pattern again. This is done in exactly the same way as for the first railing, but an additional component, the flat bars, is added. Again, we will use this face as the direction and the connection pattern parameter as the number. The preview fits, we can also confirm here. This completes our template, and as a small test we change a parameter, for example the new side distance. In the background we can see how the sketch has changed. Update in SolidSteel, looks good, we can start the Learn Railing feature. Nothing new here, we can even use the preview image again as the railing looks the same from the side. The first two parameters are disabled for user input but visible again, and we can confirm with execute, which adds the new railing to the database. Of course, we test our new side mount railing again, we already know this assembly with the two beams. We start the railing feature. This time we select the side of the web as the face, choose the side railing, get the preview, adjust the side offset as well as the start and end offset. Confirm and the railing is inserted. Looks good, a second one directly for the angled beam. In the preview, we can see from the blue arrow that the Z-axis is facing the wrong direction. No problem, we just have to activate the flip option to correct this. The rest of the parameters are the same as before, but I increased the number of center posts to 3 so that we can have a look at this feature as well. Confirm and here is the result, adapted to the slope and with 3 inner posts or 4 segments, depending on what you want to count. The railings shown are now without mounting plates and other finesse to keep the video reasonably short, but I think that was already a lot of content. However, the methods shown provide a toolbox that is sufficient to create your own more complex railing types by combining constraints, parameters, and patterns. If you like, you can also add more operations such as cuts and the like. We wish you every success, and if you would like to see how easy it is to combine stairs and railings with SolidSteel parametric, check out the video suggested here. Thanks for watching and see you next time.